This section should give a short introduction to onboard medical publications, the ship's medical stores and emergency kits, the difference between dressings and bandages, use of dressings, use of roller bandages and their applications, use of triangular bandages and their many applications, limb immobilization using bandages, dressing, bandage and sling improvisation, and splint improvisation. Aboard many ships there are medical publications dealing with shipboard emergencies. A useful one is the Ship Captain's Medical Guide. Also, the WHO publishes the International Medical Guide for Ships. Crew members should make themselves acquainted with all of these onboard medical publications and know their location and the location of all first aid and emergency kits, as well as the location of and the responsible person for the ship's medical stores. In all first aid kits, there will usually be a collection of dressings, slings and bandages. Also, they will often contain a variety of splints. Crew members should be aware of the contents of the emergency kits. A dressing is used directly on a wound. Care should be taken when opening dressing packages to not touch the wound contact surfaces and always use a dressing larger than the wound. Standard dressings come in many different sizes and packages. They are made of cotton or linen, gauze and elasticized material and are packaged in a roll. There are three main types of roller bandage. Elasticated, for securing dressings and supporting injuries like sprains. Crepe, for firm support to injured joints. Open weave, that allow ventilation but do not support joints or apply pressure. They are applied by working up a limb in overlapping spirals. They are used in a figure of eight around knees and elbows. On hands, bandage from the inside of the wrist, leaving the thumb free. Use diagonal turns across the back of the hand. One of the most useful shipboard bandages is the triangular bandage, which has many uses in first aid. A triangular bandage is made of calico or similar material by cutting a meter square diagonally across and can be used as a temporary dressing if opened straight from a sterile pack. There is an apex or point, a base and two sides. Open out the triangular bandage and lay it flat on a clean surface. Then fold it horizontally so that the point touches the center of the base. Then fold the triangular bandage in half again in the same direction. This type of bandage is used to immobilize and support limbs and secure splints and bulky dressings. First, fold a triangular bandage to make a broad fold bandage. Then fold the bandage horizontally in half again to make a thick, long and narrow bandage. This bandage is used to immobilize limbs for wrists, ankles and feet, as well as to hold eye and other dressings in place. Large arm sling. Open out the triangular bandage. Explain to the patient that it helps if the patient holds their arm across their chest, lifting when necessary when fixing the bandage. Place the triangular bandage under the arm and around the back of the neck. Then put the other half of the bandage over the arm to meet at the shoulder and tie it over the shoulder with a reef knot on the uninjured side. Use a safety pin or tuck the loose ends of the bandage in at the elbow. Collar and cuff or wrist sling. Use a narrow fold bandage and make a clove hitch round the wrist. Support the wrist by tying off with a reef knot at the opposite shoulder to the injured wrist. Use the collar and cuff sling for a suspected fracture of the collarbone or elbow when a triangular sling is not available. Place the hand on the bandage with the wrist at the base of the triangular bandage. It is useful to separate the fingers with soft material to prevent them rubbing on each other. Bring the top of the triangle over the fingers and tuck any extra material into the pleats on each side of the hand. Cross the ends on top of the hand, taking them around the wrist and secure them with a reef knot. A foot bandage is very similar. Use a narrow fold bandage. Place palm down on its middle and take the ends across the back of the hand in between the thumb and index finger. Wrap round the wrist and finish with a reef knot on the back of the hand. Only use if there is no suspected fracture of the elbow. Apply a triangular bandage to the elbow with bandage folded in half and the apex or point of the bandage halfway up the back of the top half of the arm. The arm is bent at the elbow and lies in the middle of the folded bandage. The base ends of the bandage are taken across the forearm, crossing at the elbow bend, and taken up round the upper arm in a figure of eight, and tied in a reef knot at the back of the upper arm. Fold down the apex. Take the ends of a triangular bandage round the back of the head with the point in the air. The base of the bandage should be just above the eyebrows. Lower the point to pass between the two ends and make the ends fast with a reef knot on the forehead. Attach the apex to the top of the bandage. Use narrow fold bandages, if necessary tied together in tandem, and place some soft padding between the arm and the body or between the legs so that the bandaging does not affect the broken or fractured limb. Bandage around the limb at intervals, avoiding the injury as much as possible. Tie the final reef knots on the uninjured side or in the middle of the body if both sides are injured. Use splints if available. For an improvised dressing, use any clean or sterile, preferably white material that is lint-free, such as a pillowcase, sheet, or a towel, or even a sanitary pad. Bandages can be improvised from pillows, sheets, belts, ties, and any fabric cut to form a triangle or rolled into a narrow or broad bandage. Slings that support an arm can be used from scarf, belt, tie, or anything that will go round a neck. The arm can also be supported inside a button jacket or pinning a sleeve to the clothing. When improvising a splint, make sure it is padded with soft material and it is long enough to reach the joint above and below a fracture. For thigh bones, the splint should run from armpit to ankle. Narrow bandage the splint at least above and below the fracture, and also at the ends of the splint. Use sticks, dunnage, boards, metal pieces, newspapers, magazines, cardboard, broom handles, pillows, etc.